a big dumb fun show starring Finkman.
Just where do you think you're going? I was gonna sell some rubber nipples.
And Aaron Gnerk.
I don't know how many times I've told those boys never call chicks bras.
With Mark the Big Guy and Apple Snatch Jackson.
Well, I better get going. The show's almost gone.
The Big Dumb Fun Show starts now.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another episode, another edition. Another 3 hours of the Big Dumb Fun Show. My name is Aaron.
I'm Bankman, and tonight we got quite the program planned for you. In fact, we may have more program than we have show
than is legally allowed. No, I think we have
legally
enough,
allowed by
I,
radio.
I think we've got enough show. We just got a lot more program.
Either way, we have retain the amount of time that the show is, and we have a lot of stuff that we have to get to tonight. How many guests we got coming on tonight? About 10, 15, something like that?
I think at least 12.
We're going to kick things off with Kelly Erb, the tax girl.
Yeah, from taxgirl.com.
We've talked with her this will be the third year
in a row. She contacted us, followed up. I mean, it's that time of the year.
Yeah.
And, apparently we're a favorite of her her associates at the law firm.
Well, that's cool because she does everything. She does the CNN, the Fox News. She makes the rounds because she's the go-to gal. When it comes to tax stuff, I friended up with her on the Facebook. I've even asked
I like to know that we're
questions.
At least a little more popular than, say, CNN.
Yeah,
with her
we
friends.
Should ask her. We should put her on the spot and be like, which would you rather interview with?
Oh, don't do that.
Wolf Blitzer?
She doesn't want
to. Or the Venkman, right?
Because then Wolf will call. What do you mean you'd rather talk to the Venkman?
Does Wolf really, does he even... Is he still on CNN? I have no idea.
Well, there's another war outbreak, and he's got some going. I got some work going on.
I got work.
I'm Wolf Blitzer.
So we'll see if she would rather interview
really
with Wolf Blitzer or myself. And
somebody, how about Don King?
Don King.
No, not Don King. Larry King.
Larry King. Larry King is almost retired and almost dead.
I know. That's what I'm talking about.
So which would she rather interview with?
If she had
Larry
the opportunity.
King or myself? If she had the opportunity to interview with Larry King?
If Larry came out of retirement.
I would take it.
I know.
I would interview with Larry King.
I know. You'd be like, Kelly would be here, and you'd be with Larry.
I'm like, I've always been here with Kelly here. I love her.
But it's great. She comes. I mean, she's getting more and more publicity. She's on more and more different trade magazines,
TV shows, radio shows.
And, but apparently she likes the Big Dumb Fun Show.
We're on her short list, and that's great. And actually, an associate in her office likes us too, and that's she's like, oh, you got to go back on this show. So that was really cool to hear. What else we got going on tonight? We have is it Casey Jubilee coming up?
No, it's not the Jubilee. It's actually the AMC Theaters Kansas City Film Fest.
The Film Fest.
It's going to be this week, like Wednesday through Saturday. Films at the Main Street AMC Theater.
That's a nice one too.
That's a very nice one. All week long, premieres, after parties, workshops.
That's the AMC filmmakers. You can get a beer at.
I believe so.
You can get an adult beverage and then go watch a movie
watch
or
a
two.
Film.
Watch a just film made by, is it all independent filmmakers, basically?
Well, it is, but there are certainly some levels of professionalism there. All these entries are judged, and they're not just submitted and accepted. They've got a group of people that review all the films to make them approve them. And then, but at the same time, there are films that have been in South by Southwest.
We have an actor-actress team, though, that is going to be on the show.
Jennifer Blanc.
And her husband?
Michael.
Mark? Oh, I thought it would be cool if his name was Mark Blanc.
No, not Mark Blanc.
Mark Blanc.
Michael.
Michael Blanc.
No, Michael Bain.
Bine.
Is it Bine or Bain? I wasn't sure.
I said Bine.
B-I-E-H-N.
We'll ask
him. You might
him.
Know him. He was in Aliens 2. No, Aliens.
Aliens.
It was a sequel, wasn't it? They didn't put a 2 on that.
No, because it was Alien, then Aliens, and then what was Aliens 3? He was one of the foot soldiers in Aliens, so we'll talk with him and his lovely wife.
They've got a film in the Jubilee, Kansas City
right?
Film Fest. Yeah, it's The Victim.
The Victim.
A Grindhouse-style film.
Oh, I love The Grindhouse. Who
and then
somebody else?
And then supposedly there's going to be some other filmmakers. We kind of put a call out there. And maybe even, if we're very lucky, Fred Andrews, who's the president and founder of the Kansas City Filmmakers Jubilee,
awesome.
Which has been merged with Kansas City Film Fest. to make one big Kansas City, you know, film it extravaganza.
And that's just half the show because our buddy Todd Sheets will
Night
be
Watch.
He was with the Night Watch radio program. Also brought us out to Comic Con this year, and he's going to be out, and that's going to be awesome when we have him in. In fact, in honor of Todd Sheets, I've even got a little Jedi superstar right here. I don't know if you can see that at home or on the radio, folks, but I got a little Jedi superstar. I told him last time we were on his show that I still had the CDs in my car.
And you did.
And I did. In
you
fact,
weren't lying.
Just recently,
they were that good. You don't even have a CD player in your car.
Well, you know, I still got the tape. I don't think CD's going to catch on. This is a Full Tilt MF-er. Is what this one is called.
You think this is radio-friendly material?
Probably not. And this one is called Punk Out With Your Junk Out. And, of course, the big one. Look at the back of this, too.
Get that up on the camera.
Going to California is the name of this one.
You need your Stretch Armstrong arms. Get that right up on the...
There we go. Bruce Hedrick's watching now thinking, ooh. Who knows if that's a dude's Jägermeister or not. But so I'm going to have him on tonight. And then Kilroy, Jim Kilroy, who we also met at the Comic-Con, has got a big, another one of his Club Wars things he's talking about, and he wants to come by. And I want to talk to him if he comes in, because I told him flat out.
Don't they have the Banzai Award show coming up here?
He wants to talk about that, but I want to talk about this Comic-Con.
Do you think
I'm excited
maybe
about
wants
that.
Us to... Give away one of the awards?
I'm thinking we may take an award. You know what I'm saying? We may take that SOB.
Well, I mean, what award would that be?
Guitarist the award? I'll take any award.
Righteous Ficus?
Righteous Ficus is such an underrated band. All right, but folks, that's not all.
What? There's more?
Scott Kessler.
Is going to stop in studio.
Whose grandmother or mother-in-law or someone died last week, couldn't get him in. I said, you know what? If you can stop by tonight, we will squeeze you in. His movie, Paragon, made it into the Bare Bones Film Festival, and so we're going to talk about that. It's going to be a very an eclectic show tonight, talking taxes, talking film. When we come back, I want to talk a little bit about Obama announcing his presidency run.
Yeah.
I was shocked.
What, you didn't think he wasn't going to go for two?
I didn't know if he'd go for two or not.
I think the retirement package is much better when you do two terms.
When you do two?
Isn't it?
I don't know. Is he participating in the 401k? Kelly Applesnatch Jackson will probably show up late to the show as always. And
she said she was going to be here.
Mark the Big Guy's got his big sports nuts hanging out. And Gnerk is in a brand new pad. We're very happy. In fact, when we come back, let's talk a little bit about what happened this week in your brand new bachelor pad.
I haven't had the chance to break it in yet.
Oh, yeah. You need to break it in. You need to break that sucker in. You'll be breaking us in if you're a new listener to the Big Dumb Fun Show.